Alright, so we're going to quickly just test some audio. This is the audio from the DXO One. It's a mono microphone that's sort of built in to the camera. It does a fairly good job of picking up voice, but at the same time, there's a ton of noise on it, and it sounds kind of like an internal microphone on a camera. So what I'm also doing here is recording using a Shure MV88 microphone, which is just out of frame here below the picture. So using this microphone here. This is a built-in and it's on this device. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna sync the audio here in just a second, and I'm gonna sync it with the video externally through like iMovie on the iPad to see how that works and just get a feel for the difference between the audio coming from the DXO-1 as opposed to the Shure MV88 microphone. Again, speaking to it here wirelessly and syncing in post. All right, guys, so here's a quick behind the scenes of how I synced the audio from the Shure MV88, which I recorded externally on my iPhone, to the video, which was shot on my DXO-1 camera, and then syncing that all up in iMovie, the app on my iPad. So that was a lot of words, but regardless, this is kind of where we're at. So what you want to do is more or less get the file from the iPhone into the iPad. The easiest way I found to do it was just simply AirDrop the file and then open it up in iMovie. And then from there, once you're in iMovie, your audio is going to be under imported tracks. So from here, you're just going to go ahead and import the audio. You'll just click that and then use that. And then that will be in the background, and then from there you switch over to the media button here, and then you want to get the video that you just recorded on the DXO-1, or you know, whatever footage you have that goes with the audio, and then you're going to drop that onto the timeline as well. So now you've got two things going on. You've got basically the video file that's muted, and then you have the, in green, you've got the external audio from the Shure MV88. Another thing that you want to do when you're in iMovie is make sure that you're looking at waveforms, because otherwise you don't really have a way to sort of visually sync the audio with the video. Right now you can see here, I basically did a couple claps before the video actually started, pre-roll, just to sync so I can, you know, basically have an easy visual cue in terms of where to sync up the audio. But now what I need is the video, the waveforms on the audio track from the Shure MV88, which is in green and which you can't see here. So the easiest way for me to do that was just simply put it in the foreground. So once you put the audio in the foreground, then you have the waveforms that you need. And you can see here that it's off sync, at least the external audio in blue to the video file in gray. So then the simplest way to do is just click and drag the audio file and just drop it kind of right over where you want it to go. And then from there, what you should have is some nicely synced audio and video. So those claps look like they line up pretty well. And then from there, you can check the rest of the video.
Quickly just test some audio. This is the audio from
and it looks fairly good. Obviously, if you have more complicated setup, more other files, other clips, it gets a little messy, and editing an iMovie on an iPad isn't necessarily the easiest thing to do. But for this demonstration, it was fairly simple because it was just one audio track separate from one video and then just stitching them together in iMovie. So if you found that helpful, please like the video. It helps me out. And subscribe if you want to see more stuff like this in the future. Thanks for watching, appreciate it, and we'll catch you in the next one. Peace.